Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the All Gracious, the All Merciful. Assalamu alaikum, my dear brothers and sisters. And thank you so much for listening again for another supplication. Tonight, I'm going to talk a little bit about the 26th day supplication as follows. O Allah, on this day, make my efforts worthy of appreciation, and my sins forgiven, my deeds accepted, my flaws concealed, all the best of those who hear. In this supplication and the dua, according to spiritual masters and teachers, there are some interpretations and some explanations. First of all, we ask God that, O God, accept our prayers. You know, sometimes we work for 40 days, we work for a year, we work for a long time, and just one sin and one flaw can destroy all of our a'mal and our deeds and our good deeds in before God the Almighty. How? For example, as you have a big garden, one small match fire can fire all the garden and forest. Sins and especially the major sins are like this. For example, backbiting and also insulting a brother or sister. Nothing is worse than, you know, insulting your brother and sister for God the Almighty. God may forgive the sins that you have done in regard with Himself, with God, but will not forgive the sins and also the backbitings or the, for example, insulting or anything related to others until they themselves forgive you. So this is very important, and this is why we ask God, oh God, give us the grace and blessings that these, for example, 30 days that we fast in the month of Ramadan, so to be accepted. So what is the way that if we have done a sin, for example, that God the Almighty ignore the sin? According to the to the mystics, repentance. Repentance is the key that God Almighty to forgive you, and constantly asking, oh God, save me from the happening, save me from the bad attributes of the moment, of today, of this situation that we have. So this is one point, and we have a hadith that sometimes we see a small flaw of our brother or sister, but we forget the biggest one in our side. We have sometimes to concentrate in our own flaws and sins, not others. Okay. And the second point is that, and my sins to be forgiven, and my deeds to be multiplied. So this month, the month of Ramadan, is the month of forgiveness. You know, that is why it is called the spring of the mystics, because in this month God forgives the sins without question. And in the dua of Sha'ban, the month of Sha'ban, which is before Ramadan, we have hadith from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that those who have a big pack, a backpack of sins and flaws, so they can repent and to be forgiven in the month of Ramadan. And there is one other point, that why sometimes we do not have the mood for dua and prayer and supplication. According to ahadith and hadiths from our imams and from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sins, and also the flaws we have, the characteristics, bad characteristics, negative characteristics that we have, are like the chains that stick us, and also can do not let us to, for example, wake up in the middle of the night and pray. So sometimes we do not have the mood for prayer. It is because we have forgotten God, and also we have forgotten ourselves, and this is the main reason. One of the main attributions of God Almighty is that He is the best friend. He is the best sincere company, that who is always beside us and always watching us and always helping us. So this was for tonight, and I hope that there were some points in my presentation. If anyone has any points, please share with the group and for tonight's supplication. So have a good time, and wassalamu alaikum.